The WHO estimates that about 119 million people around the world are in need of refractive error detection or services, and about 90% of those people are in developing countries. You don't really think of vision impairment as one of the huge health challenges or health burdens around the world, but there are studies that have been published that estimate that about $42 billion US dollars are lost in a single year due to the loss of productivity that people encounter from having impaired vision. So in your doctor's office, there are a couple of different technologies that are used. The most common is objective refraction, which uses an autorefractor, which is simply just a machine that is oriented on your into your eye, mm-hmm. and the test is performed, and it just gives out a reading. There's also subjective refraction, which is done using a fovopter, in which the user will say, is one better or is two better, and then the user will give that feedback. Mm-hmm. Very large pieces of equipment, they're bulky, they're expensive. The autorefractor is on the order of $5,000 to $6,000. The fovopter for the subjective refraction is on the order of $1,000 to $2,000. If you need to do eye tests in a rural health clinic where there is a lot of dust or there is limited power accessibility, and most importantly, a lack of trained technicians, which is one of the biggest shortages in these remote settings, then you simply cannot perform the test.
Amy is part of a team at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology that is designing an alternative test for long and short-sightedness. The technology known as Netra requires nothing more than a small eyepiece that can clip onto a smartphone.
This technology it's composed of a simple hardware add-on, which is on the order of about $30 in its current prototype version, that clips onto a cell phone, and there's software on the cell phone, and all it is a simple self-administered eye test. So this technology employs what's called the reverse Shack-Hartman theorem. And it's a lensless system that employs a simple mask. And the real key here is that the resolution of the screens on cell phones in the modern market is so high that we can utilize that to really enable the kind of resolution that you can get with whatever you find in an optometrist's office here in Boston. It's very easy to use. It can be administered by the user with minimal assistance from a technician, so the amount of training required has been reduced. It's orders of magnitude less expensive than the technology that's currently out there, and it's portable. It's easy. You can just plop it onto a cell phone and use it anywhere in the world. So with this, we have a cell phone and a hardware add-on that clips securely onto the phone. And to perform a test, you simply hold it up to your eye, and an app on the phone will direct you and tell you what to do. And you perform a simple test where you'll see two circles. You align them in a number of steps, and the number of steps that it takes for you to align those two circles corresponds to your refractive error, and that's how we can determine that reading.
Netra stands for Near Eye Tool for Refractive Assessment. The concept was developed at a section of MIT known as the Media Lab, in collaboration with Brazil's Federal University of Rio de Janeiro. The device is now being used in trials around the world. Amy hopes that one day the device can become a standard part of a doctor's toolkit for parts of the developing world.
So our main entry point into this market will be in India, where we have a wide variety of contacts already at vision institutes around that country, and where there is a documented need for this technology. Now, our vision for disseminating this technology is to take it and put it in the hands of every healthcare worker that's going on every trip to every community. And so in their toolbox of like a stethoscope, a blood pressure monitor, they also have this technology with the cell phone that they're already carrying with them anyway, that they can simply plop on and do a test in a matter of minutes to add this health metric to their database.